Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta, and welcome back to Hades. Thank you, everybody, for the support here. We're going to need more of it if you want to see Hades become a regular thing. I am starting here today with a shield run. I'm using the Zeus aspect, which is a new shield that I've never actually played with. It replaces our special with Blitz Disc. I'm not sure what that is. And I've got the owl keepsake going right now because I wanted to obviously get the Deflect Dash, which we've just now gotten from Athena. Yeah, so that is the Blitz Disc. Interesting. But the shield is my favorite weapon in the game. Some people say that it's easy mode. I say I'm just playing it as the devs intended it. But again, I do want to say it. Thank you again for the support on the Hades series. I want to see more of it, though. If y'all want to see it as a regular series here on the channel, then let me know by clicking the like button, also in the comments down below, and tell me what your favorite weapon is so far in Hades. Love the shield. The shield's just too good, man. Too good. I've bumped it up to 2 heat. We're still kind of playing baby mode right now because I'm still just kind of getting used to, I don't know, just the flow of things. I'm not ready to go up to like 10 heat yet. That'd be the next transition, I think, that we go for. But 2 heat is not necessarily that difficult. I slightly increased the amount of mobs that we see per room, like 40% more. So it's nothing too major. And of course, with the shield and how proficient I am with it, I'm not worried about 40% more enemies. 40% more damage, I would be a little bit worried about. So we can't actually go in here either because it requires 5 heat. So that's okay. We'll go get ourselves a palm. All right, let's see here. I didn't actually mean to go that way. Unfortunately, you cannot dart your way over you can't shield charge your way over a gap. It doesn't really make a whole lot of sense, but I guess in theory, I'm pretty sure that Supergiant knows that the shield is probably the strongest weapon in the game. At least I think it is anyway. And I'm not the only one who feels that way. I'm not saying that I'm the only person who plays this game, of course, but I'm just saying that I think most people know that the shield is pretty darn strong.
Good enough to eat.
Vine Dash level 2, sure. Cheers. We need to give ourselves another aspect. This is going to be a boss. This is going to be darkness. Let me get some more gems. Okay, so there's a well of Charon here. I'm going to try to use the Blitz Disc as much as I can. And by the way, thank you everyone for telling me on the last, I think it was the last episode when we had the spear, about the special being for the spear not being the twirly bird, but the actual, like, you know, when Zagreus throws it out and then he recalls it, which I didn't use at all because I never ever played with the spear, which I probably should. But the twirly bird attack with the spear is actually the charged attack one, and that's the one I erroneously called the special attack. Or the cast, I mean. Life Essence, we can get an instant heal right now. We have plus 1 Bloodstone for our Prometheus Stone. I don't think we need any of these. I mean, we could heal ourselves for 36 gold, but I'm gonna roll the dice. We got a shop here or darkness? Give me a shop. Give me an early shop here.
Sounds like Charon's breathing up ahead.
All right, Charon. And we got, oh man, why? No hammer.
Cheers, mate.
Let's see, special's 12% faster. You move 30% faster. Greater haste. Yes, please. Haste of Hermes. Thank you, Hermes.
Ready, Lance?
Now remember, we do have the deflect dash, which means that every time that we dash, we give ourselves a little bit of an immunity, iframes to spells and whatnot. And unlike other games, you don't actually get iframes in this game when you dash immediately. Oh, we get Dio as well. Hello, Dio.
I heard Athena had a word with you already, yeah? She's cool, though, once you get to know her. Here, I got something that ought to suit her style.
Got a duo, maybe? Light Strike, I mean, I like Dionysus' aid, but you gotta go poison here. And, let me give some more keys. Thank you, Dio. So now our basic attacks are going to cause poison damage, which is very, very strong in the game, as you all are well aware of. Between the two status effects, I think poison is easily stronger than doom. Unless there's another type of status effect that I'm unaware of. Which is possible, because I haven't seen the entire game yet. Throw out the Blitz Disc. Now, the nice thing about the Blitz Disc is that we don't actually have to catch it. In order for us to keep using our shield, but you see there, all I have to do is if I tap Q again, it will actually bring the disc back to me. So there, I hit Q, and then I can tap it again, and it's going to start making its way back. As you see here, I still maintain a shield, regardless if the special is out twirling about or not. We get some nice wall damage there. Just going to run out the clock here on these noobs, and that'll be it. Get some Centaur HP here as well. I like being tanky when I've got the shield. And we also have a Trial Trove. Hopefully it's a heal. That'd be nice just to top ourselves off before we go fight one of the Furies. It seems like the Blitz Disc doesn't do that good of damage, but I guess there's no reason not to use it since it doesn't prevent us from doing our basic attack anyway. Nice little area of effect. Control area that we can throw out at random. We can recall it back if necessary. I wonder if it actually... Does the Blitz Disc... Does it make you... Does it stack up poison, I wonder? This is going to be gems. Might as well do it. Okay, yeah. It does not spread poison, and that's okay. I wouldn't expect it to be since it's considered a cast anyway, or a special, so... Not that big of a deal. Speaking of casts, I haven't been using my bloodstones. Whenever I take a day off of Hades or 2 days off, I always have to sort of like reteach myself the game for half a second. Damnable fools.
Very nice.
So we got some gemstones here. Got more keys, or we can get nectar. Give me more keys. I want to try to unlock more stuff from the mirror. We got witches. Of course, witches we don't care about at all because obviously we can just dash right through all of their attacks. I'm tossing out the bloodstone casts here just so we can maintain a decent amount of damage while not on the primary target. I think there's one more. There we go. Try to throw out the Blitz Disc there. I think I may have accidentally caught it. I took a hit there at the very, very end. That's all right. All right. We've got ourselves Sisse, possibly. I guess it could be Eurydice as well, but I'm going to go for the coin. It's unfortunate that we didn't have enough gold to pay for the Daedalus Hammer. For the shield, that's pretty important. I am loving our increased movement speed of 30%, though, thanks to the Hermes Boon. That's going to be pretty substantially important. Mobility in Hades is quite an important stat, even though it's overlooked a lot of the time, I think. It's like movement speed in Isaac as well. You can't dodge stuff if you're not able to get out of the way in time.
Coin for Charon.
That's my Booger McFarland analysis of today. Throw out the Blitz Disc here. There's a lot of casters in this room here, but we're doing okay just chewing through them all. I need to do a better job at not standing on traps or not even like darting towards traps. I tend to take a lot of damage accidentally. So we have a palm, an infernal portal, but we can't go down there because we're not at 5 heat, so I guess we're just going to go to the shop. This should be the last one here. We are able to get the Daedalus Hammer this time. Okay, it has a power shot. It deals 400% damage to armor. Yeah, I think we got to go for the armor shredder. I like the Minotaur Rush is okay, but it's sort of finicky in the timing, and I don't want to have to try to guess that out every time.
Guess I was wrong.
Not Meg. What's her name?
Know something, Red?
Yeah, Electo.
Can take time.
Yeah. Yeah. Get the bloodstones on her as fast as possible. Now, she doesn't actually have any armor, so I'm just trying to get ourselves a good amount of damage on her with our poison damage. She's enraged right now. Gonna wait for her shield to come down before I use the bloodstones on her. It's just pure aggression on her. Not gonna let her get a chance to go full enrage on us.
She wasn't very nice.
Okay, good first floor. Took a little bit too much damage more damage than I'm liking, but at the end of the day, we got deflect dash down. We're okay. All right, so we could go. I don't think we need to get Myrmidon Bracer right now. And I'm not good enough at the game to get any use out of the Pierce Butterfly. Traps the Falling Rebel, deal 200% damage to foes. Next boon you find will be from Ares. I wouldn't mind getting Ares' Call. I say let's roll the dice, and let me just take the Black Shawl for now.
Go with that one.
Have 33 gold. Go ahead and go for Eyes of Lamia. Let's head on down, or up. The Asphodel. Here we are in Asphodel, and we're going to start off with an HP upgrade. Yeah, buddy. Again, I'm hoping that we get a full-fledged series on Hades. I really would. I'm gonna stick with it. So people, for those of you who are already kind of despairing about the numbers, don't fret about them too much yet. I'm still gonna stick with Hades for a little while. Just as far as like an actual full-blown series or not, that's the one that kind of depends on the numbers here. Something else to keep in mind as well is that Hades episodes do take a lot longer than I'd like. Especially given the run length of Bumbo and that stuff, and of course a bad Isaac run, don't really have a whole lot of time for a third game that could take a long time to do. But I do think that Hades could be a good YouTube series though, especially when we start turning up the heat and cranking up the difficulty a little bit more. But I'm not there yet. I feel like I need to get better. I need to get more proficient with all the weapons, not just the shield, but all of the weapons. Especially the bow. So we get our HP upgrade here. This is going to be more gemstones.
It's mine.
You shall pay for that.
No one pays for anything down here, Dad. A little bit of a weird lag there. It wasn't allowing me to charge the bull rush for some reason. Gonna try to stack up the poison damage here on this jerk. All right, so we only got 10 that time, which is pretty bad.
Can't do that.
But at the end of the day, it's still 10 gemstones. It costs us a little bit of HP to get there. And now we've got more gems, keys, or darkness. I'm gonna go for dark just for the heal since we did take the Black Shawl. Black Shawl is gonna heal us for 100% of the crystals gained. I was hoping that we're gonna get a Chaos Gate because I wanted to increase our overall darkness gain. It's a pretty nice little boon that Chaos can give you. Get the blitz disc out there a little bit. Now it would be nice if the blitz disc actually did add poison stacks to it. Oh, there, I hit the recall on the disc. Trying to shred the armor of this launcher real fast. Good hit there with that charge. Although we got hit by the retaliatory inferno bomb. Now, it is possible, if you have any sort of deflect, you can deflect, as you saw right there, you can deflect the bombs back at them. But I still think that, I'm pretty sure that Zagreus incurs a friendly fire penalty anyway, if he's around where they land. Get a 10 HP heal there, we've got HP, we've got a shop. Got all kinds of stuff. We got a well down here. 15%. Now let's go for a Light of Ixion. I'd like to get a Chaos Gate from Chaos. Shop Hermes again. Or HP. Give me HP. Nice. Nice little fountain room here. That is fine by me. And we immediately accidentally jump into the lava. Good job, Invicta. Go see Artemis. There's our Chaos Gate.
Oh god, I love snakes.
Now, of course, I'm using the bull rush here because I want to strip the armor off of the Medusa head. A little bit of healing there. It's amazing how we always end up somehow in lava. Yeah, I've got my bloodstones back. Oh, that hit me, huh? Alright, what's Artemis got to say?
Because I seldom share the greatest of my hunting secrets like I am about to.
Okay. Call. Your cast seeks foes. 10% chance to deal critical damage. Special is stronger. Special is stronger with a 20% chance to deal critical damage. This is tough. I'm not a huge fan of Artemis's call. Let's go with Deadly Flourish. Let's see what we can do with the Blitz Disc here.
Might as well.
All right, let's go see Chaos.
Oof. I understand the hunting goddess Artemis recently has turned her gaze towards you. It is unexpected she would offer her assistance. Even to a relative in need.
In plus 36 HP, there's the one, Caustic Eclipse. Okay, so all we have to do is survive. We have to survive three encounters with Inferno Bombs being tossed at us. And let's go for Darkness just so we can stay top, but we need to be careful about the Inferno Bombs. 173% Darkness is pretty good.
Ready for me?
Die in the lava, all right. Make my job easier. Yeah, I was able to deflect the Inferno Bomb at the last second you saw right there, thankfully. Poison stacked up here. Need to keep on moving after they die because we don't want to get hit by the Inferno Bombs. This Medusa head was phasing through the wall over here. All right, not really fair, but you know, whatever, game.
No problem.
Okay, so we've got ourselves a shop, which we don't have a whole lot of gold with, or we could go to Athena. More, another tro trial for gems, sure, why not? At this point, the gemstones.
Interloper.
Might as well. Damage on the brimstones there.
Wait.
Alright, 13 is not terrible. We got just over half of what we of the maximum there. So we've got Athena or another store. I think we should go to the store to heal. I think that the barge is coming up next.
Greetings, Charon.
Or this might be the last. This might be the last store. I'm entirely sure. Heal. We get darkness. Unfortunately, we can't get Ares. A little bit short there.
Just what I need.
And we don't technically need the darkness, so I'm gonna save the gold. And yeah, Hydra time.
I wouldn't mess with me if I were you.
I gotta remember we don't have any call here. But with the poison that we've got from Dionysus, it should be a pizza cake. I mean, I have yet to ever lose to the Hydra. And I'm not about to start right now. Gonna sit here and stack up poison on this one Hydra head. That one's dead. There you go. See how fast that we're able to strip there with the bull rush on that armor. That yellow bar that you see on enemies, that is the armor that enemies have, and we have the increased ability to destroy that very, very quickly here. Deflect a bunch of those shots back in its stupid Hydra face. There we go. Phase two. Yeah, we've got two of them on top of each other over here. That's fine. Take this heal while we can. Oh, wow. That Hydra head jumped up at, like, the precise moment that we were about to strip the armor. Like, I'm not going over here into the lava game. No, see, the thing is, you gotta come down here. I ain't going up there. And then a phase three here, then that'd be that. You saw the Inferno Bomb is still active from the Chaos Gate, despite us being on a boss fight. I think we're getting hit from the back there by those casts from the main Hydra. Okay, that side's done. We got Blitz Disc helping us out there. And let's finish off this stupid Hydra. He looks so... The Hydra looks so derpy when he throws out, like, a billion of those little purple casts that he does. He's just not even trying to hit you. I think we call that the old Hydra spray and pray. Heal us up. Yeah, the Hydra wasn't anything crazy. Passive attack bonus here. For 40, I think that we're okay. And let's head on up to Elysium.
Take me up. Thank you.
Alright, here we are in my least favorite place in the game. Oh boy, this is tough. We need gold. The coin can get us HP anyway, which is why I'm going for the coin here instead of going for the centaur fortitude. I'm not sure how everyone feels about Elysium. I definitely don't like it because the mobs are quite cheap in a way. That, and I hate these statues. As I always point out, these statues are just terrible because you can't, they blend in with the size of the level so well. You can never really tell if they're gonna like swing on you or not, or if you can't tell if they're just decoration. Another thing that I dislike about Elysium is that it does feel like there's a little too many mobs in per room, but that might just be a personal gripe of mine. Another one of these pink. Oh, two of them now. Look at us getting fancy. Okay, got some gold there.
From chaos has a new effect.
We don't have to worry about the chaos boon anymore. We've got Ares or a palm. Let's have a well here. 29 gold for a heal like that's pretty good. I'm gonna take that. I think that we should go for Ares here. Because we need to get an impervious call for me to feel comfortable against Hades. I fought him without imperviousness, but it's difficult. I'd rather have everything easier if possible. I mean, one thing about Hades that a lot of people probably don't get a feel for unless they actually play it, I guess it's sort of like Isaac in a way, is that Hades is a very difficult game. I would say that the skill ceiling on Hades is probably far greater than on Isaac. I think that's a fair assessment to say. More witches here.
Good night.
Gonna use my poison to chew through the HP of the more tankier mobs here. All right.
Ah, my kin. I sensed fresh bloodshed from you recently, the real kind. You have slain the living near the surface, have you not? Mere vermin, yes, but good enough for me.
There's the call right there. Oh man, bonus damage though. Your attack special and cast deals 10% more damage. I can't pass that up. That's a 10% flat increase. I'm gonna take a risk and see if we can get another hammer from the store. It's hard to pass up imperviousness. Well, we have Dio in here. We can't take both, though. Let's get some upgraded poison.
Should help keep me going.
Hopefully. Speed reduction for poison targets. Nasty dash, but nasty dash is nowhere near what we want with divine dash. So it comes down to, do we want poison for Dionysus' aid or the slowing effect? I say for now, we might as well go for a call just to have it. And then we have another Dio here. This one progresses the story, I think. But I'd rather I want to get more poison damage for this build.
It's that big soul catcher again.
We got a big soul catcher here. I'm going to use our bull rush to strip the armor. Okay, apparently I couldn't hit that one through the wall there. It's good to know. Yeah, so for this room you want to stop them from respawning at all costs. I used Dionysus' aid there to just poison the boss. There you go. He's Dio again. There we go. Get some good ticking damage there. I mean, I could. It could be worse if we didn't have Dionysus' call. Cast shot, lobs festive fog, poison. There's the speed reduction. We also have positive outlook. Take 40%. Take 15% less damage at 40% HP or below. Let's go with a numbing sensation.
Time to feast.
We've got palm or we've got HP. We desperately need some HP.
More bright swords.
Wonder why they call them bright swords. They look pretty dark to me. What's the deal with the bright swords? So we got Dionysus' call up coming up next. Might as well use it. Get a wall smash here or two. Yeah. Yeah. Return to sender. Definitely want to get the poison on the shield bearers. Shield bearers are definitely the worst enemy outside of the mini chariots. Dio is poisoning everything. We're still taking chip damage from something. I'm not sure what. Get the heal here. Well, technically not a heal, I suppose. Just checking for a well. Doesn't look like we got a well. Oh, we do have a well. Joke's on me. This actually gets us a lot more than just six, than this 21. We can actually heal off of this for less than half the cost of this. Yeah.
It.
That healed us for 57. More HP or gold? Ooh, boy. We do need more HP, but I'm going to go for the risky play here and get for more gold.
I hear something.
In the name of Hades.
And here comes Thanos.
You look like you could use a hand.
Really don't need a hand here, Thanatos. I've got two of them.
Occasionally, yes.
Thanos, he stole all of those, huh?
Olympus. No, you don't. Dionysus. You don't test this.
Not exactly sure what that what this void is that Thanatos throws out on the ground. I don't know if that means anything that's killed in there counts for Thanatos or not, but Thanatos actually beats me for the first time. Just kind of lame.
Rude.
Oh, and then he just pieces out. So we don't get HP gain from him. That's the first time that's ever happened. I think that we were giving him some kills or something. Okay. Apparently there's a corner there that I slightly bounced off of. All right, there's a trial trove here and a well, so at least we can get something. Hopefully we can get more HP. Wow, that hit us twice through the wall. I'm going to save the call here for the next wave. We're losing way too much HP to just... see, like, right there, I'm not exactly sure what hit me. But we were getting hit by something, despite my shield being turned to it, at least I thought it was, so... I don't know. I definitely hate the shield bearers, though. We're still getting hit by something just over and over again. I gotta say, Hermes, this 30% movement speed we got from you is not really helping us right now. Olympus. We took way too much damage in here, from what I'm not entirely sure. Can't let this one come back. We only get a 27 heal there. That's gems. I don't care about gems right now. And this well of Charon is not helping us at all. We have Ares, or we have got Artemis. I think I need to go for Ares just so we can switch off of Dionysus' call. Hopefully we get an upgraded Ares call. But we are most likely going to lose a Death Defiance in here. Unless a miracle happens. Hopefully they do drop some more sandwiches. Definitely use them. Trying to spread the poison around as much as possible.
See you.
Ares, help us out.
Lord Ares, I honor you for all the strength you've given me to overcome my foes.
Such a splendid offering to me. How very thoughtful there, my kin. I am taken aback, though I accept.
Olympus, I accept this message.
Okay. After you take damage to Doom, after slaying a foe, you get 141% more. Your cast, the cast gets replaced with a Blade Rift, which is actually pretty good. Gonna go for Slicing Shot instead. We do indeed get a shop here, and the shop is pretty darn important. I could sell some, let's see what we can sell at the Sacrifice Shrine here. The Pool of Purging, I should say. Greater Haste, Light Strike, or Dionysus' Aid. All of which we're using, that's pretty important. So let's go into the store. Hopefully we get a hammer or something in here. At least a heal. We do get a heal, we get HP, we can get all of these actually.
Actually doing business. God's grant me strength.
We do finally get some more damage here. Poison damage is very, very crucial. Oh boy, this is going to be a little bit rough.
You return at your peril, Hellspawn. You'll get no quarter here.
Dionysus' Aid is going to be very, very important to have. Able to stop that lance throw there by Theseus. There we go, get our Blade Rifts back here just to get some more damage on him. That combined with some poison damage is pretty darn good. Minotaur missed the bull rush, gonna go for the call of Dionysus. taking my bloodstone back over here. So we're not burning down fast enough. As fast as I would like, anyway. But at least the blade rifts are softening them all, both of them up. They can't not be in there, so. Not entirely sure how we got hit there. I thought I was blocking that one, but I was not. And I'm just going to keep unleashing Dionysus on him over and over again. So we accidentally pushed him over to phase two here, which is not what we wanted to do with Minotaur still being up. We're just making this harder on ourselves. Damage there on Theseus. Bad time for the game to lag right there. I say the game, but I say my computer. Actually impressive how bad our damage is. We only have a level 2 poison, but the poison damage is quite forgettable that we're doing right now, or lack thereof. Let me get my bloodstones back here. Wow, our second Death Defiance? Or did we get him? I don't know why the game is going at like one frame a second there for something. Okay. That was pretty much the worst fight I've had against both of them in a long time. So we lose two Death Defiance. That's just unacceptable. I don't know how we got tagged for so much. I really wish the game would stop freezing. Gonna go back to the Myrmidon Bracer here, but that was pretty bad.
Let's think about this.
The slowing effects I don't really care about, to be honest.
Feel cleaner already.
The blade rifts the blade rift we have to keep. Gonna be an interesting finish. Alright, here we are at the Temple of Styx, and we've got our work cut out for us, that's for sure. Hopefully we get some good bonuses in here. There is HP, there's no hammer, unfortunately. I'm gonna go ahead and take the palm right now. Okay, Dionysus' aid gives us more poison, so I guess we can go for that. It's a poison upgrade. It's not the one that we wanted, but it's something. There is a hammer. We're going to go straight for that. But without us, unless if we get lucky and we find a well that has a Death Defiance for sale, going to Hades with only one HP, or with one Death Defiance is going to be... quite the challenge, man. Our poison damage is really lacking. Not the strongest shield build that I've ever had, that's for sure. Alright. Use our blade rifts to do the damage for us. That way we don't have to be in harm's way. Got poisoned all the way in this corner over here. I wasn't trying to stay over there. Got poisoned again. I can't reach my bloodstones because they went right to the middle of the room, like in a perfect center. We get poisoned again. Keeps on going, doesn't it? Got poisoned again. Gonna go with Dionysus' aid again, but he keeps missing. But I think that there's a minimum cast range for that. Get poisoned again. It seems like it's poisoning us really, really fast today. Unless I'm imagining that, which is possible. This room is still going on, but everything feels like it's going a lot longer than it's supposed to, and that's really a testament to how low our damage is. We get poisoned again. I can't reach the snake stone here. There we go. Poisoned again. Good job, Zagreus. Well done. We're finally out of this hellish hole, but good God. Dash attack, bull rush, special. I guess give me the dash attack. Wow, that was not worth it. Not at all. I think we gotta go for HP here. And honestly, I think it would be wiser for us, once we find the Satyr Sack, to just take the full heal and then just go. We can't bank on us getting one of our Death Defiance back by some random well. Hopefully we can get some HP gain here. We will have 250 HP to fight Hades with. And since we essentially get a full heal after we find the Satyr Sack, so I think that's honestly going to give us our best chance of winning. Alright, we got a giant snake stone this time around. Gotta focus on the snake stone right now. We got poison. Hmm. Okay. Wasn't too bad. We gained some HP there. Double checking to make sure I didn't miss a well or anything. Okay, so now do we take the HP or the palm first?
Look at all this.
I think we should take the HP first because if we do find the Seder Sack here, it's going to give us the heal for that amount. Go for the gold. Now, just because there's a boss, I don't believe that just because there's a boss symbol over that skull, or that door with Ares on it, I don't believe that that tells you the actual location of the Seder Sack. I could be wrong about that, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't, that doesn't, like, that makes it too easy to plan around, I think. There we go, just get them both on top of each other and then start throwing them up against the wall there. It is nice that our dash attack does have that 50% additional range, so, and I frequently, I use the dash attack more than any other ability at, with the shield. So that was a nice addition here. Pool of purging, but no well, unfortunately. I'd feel a little bit better if we had, if I had two Death Defiance instead of three. Yeah, right on cue here, we do get the heal. So 300 HP. That's a lot of HP, to be honest. So I think that we're just gonna roll with this. And we do get an upgrade here for our Blight Strike, and I am gonna go for that instead of upgrading Dionysus' Aid. And, yeah, let's just see how it goes.
Gigantic Cerberus accepts the prince's foul offering.
There you go, Cerberus. Here we go. I'm taking a risk by not going to the other halls, but I think it's a worthy risk. 300 HP, one life. Focus time.
Crisp, cold air.
I must admit to something, boy. Achilles taught you reasonably well. I expected that if anyone could train you into martial competence, it would be him.
Though you didn't expect that one day I would end up using everything I learned from him against you.
I anticipate more than you know. But Achilles merely practiced against mortals. Now you practice against me.
All right, here we go.
Darkness.
Hades the Measly is going to cloak here. So I'm going to have to play this a little more hit and runny than I like. Unfortunately, I can't hit that one skull that's in the water over here.
Yeah, boy.
I'm gonna have to sit there and block it.
Way to go.
Okay, next time he comes out, I'm going to drop Dionysus on him.
Dionysus.
You've no control. Guy dropped two stacks of Dionysus on him. That was able to push him over a little bit. Unfortunately, we got archers here. That's not what I wanted to see.
Am I brutish or am I holding back? Make up your blasted mind.
Always try to reflect those green skulls if you can. We got boiling blood on us. That's not good. What? I could have swore that I blocked up my shield. Apparently not. I guess you can also block those and they'll disappear. The blitz disc as well, just to add a little bit more damage here. Apparently I'm not hitting that one even though I was right next to it. All right, you see there, every time that he stealths he loses the poison stacks. Two here. This is really where having an impervious call helps out a lot. Apparently I didn't kill the skull. Oh, and another skull up here. Exactly sure what he's how he's hitting me over there. I'm making sure I'm keeping my shield, unless that attack is unblockable. I'm pretty sure that I'm maintaining my shield being facing him. How nice is this call completely whiffed? Not gonna make it that skull in time. One more call here. He's done it. Ugh.
Escaping that. How dare
All right, well, we're on our four streak, and that run was pretty rough, especially for a Shield run. I'm kind of disappointed how badly we did, but at the end of the day, it was a win, so it was definitely the weakest poison build that I've ever had before. But we get another Titan Blood claimed, and another Hades run done. Thank you for watching, everyone. I do appreciate it. If you want to see more Hades, make sure you're clicking the like button, leaving a comment down below. That's the best way to let me know that you want to see more Hades here on the channel. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.
I did it.